Hi, in last class we discussed about acceleration relative to rotating coordinates. Today we are going to discussing about apparent force in a rotating coordinate system. Let's see. In last class we derive an expression for the acceleration of an object with respect to inertial frame of reference that is equal to a prime, means the acceleration of that object with respect to non-inertial frame of reference. Non-inertial frame of reference, that is rotating frame of reference. A prime plus 2 omega cross v prime plus omega cross omega r. And if we want to rewrite this equation in the term of a prime, that is in the term of acceleration with respect to the non-inertial frame of reference, that means a prime is equal to a minus 2 omega cross v prime minus omega cross omega r. And we already know the term 2 omega cross v prime, this term is known as Coriolis acceleration, and the term omega cross omega r is known as centripetal acceleration. And here a prime is equal to a minus 2 omega cross v prime minus omega cross r. Here it is positive omega cross r, that is known as centripetal, but here it is negative. So just opposite to centripetal, what it is? Centrifugal. This term is centrifugal acceleration. Centrifugal acceleration. Okay, and if we consider the mass of the object, thus we consider here, and its mass we can consider it is m, and we multiplied this equation by this m, then this equation become m into a prime is equal to m into a minus 2 omega cross v prime into m minus omega cross omega r into m, right? Then what is m into a prime? According to Newton, mass into acceleration is force. So here m into a prime means f prime. And what is m a? It is f. This term is Coriolis acceleration, and we multiply this Coriolis acceleration by the value of m, then this term, this is in the term of acceleration, but here multiplied by m, this term become in the term of force. So here it is Coriolis acceleration, then here it is Coriolis force. And here omega cross omega r, it is centrifugal acceleration. So we multiplied this acceleration by the mass, then this term become centrifugal force. Means the f prime is equal to f plus Coriolis force plus centrifugal force. Right? So what is F prime? F prime is apparent force in a rotating coordinate system. So the apparent force in a rotating coordinate system is equal to F plus Coriolis force plus centrifugal force. What is F? F is the true force. Then F prime, that means the apparent force in a rotating coordinate system, is the sum of true force plus Coriolis force and centrifugal force. The summation of Coriolis force and centrifugal force is known as fictitious force. So the apparent force F prime is equal to F plus fictitious force. The fictitious force, that is the summation of Coriolis force and centrifugal force. What is Coriolis force? 2 minus 2 omega cross V prime into M. Means the value of Coriolis force is depends of two parameters, that is omega and V prime. But in the case of centrifugal force, there is only one parameter, that is omega. What is omega? Angular velocity of the rotating frame. So the Coriolis forces depends on omega and V prime. The centrifugal forces depends on omega. And the summation of Coriolis force and centrifugal force, it is known as fictitious force. And the summation of fictitious force and true force, we got the apparent force in a rotating coordinate system. So if we consider the case of actions or phenomena, those are happening in the surface of Earth. We know Earth is a rotating frame because Earth is rotating its own axis, and also it is moving around the circular orbit, central point of that orbit, that is Sun. So Earth is a rotating frame or non-inertial frame. So in that cases, means if you want to solve some problems, those are happening in the surface of Earth, that case we must follow fictitious force, Coriolis force, centrifugal force. Right? Okay, then here F prime is equal to F plus fictitious force. Then next class, definitely we solved some problems. Those are related to the Earth surface. Right? Okay.